15, spins at the 20, cuts it to the outside, the 30. He has one man to beat to the 40. He's at midfield, cuts back near side, gets by the kicker.
Senior sensation Kevin Cannon opened the 1995 season with a bang. Cannon racked up 328 yards of total offense against Shepherd in a school record 5-touchdown performance. Cannon's sensational performance keyed a 59-7 season opening win for the Marauders and served as an omen of things to come. Kevin Cannon averaged 182 yards per game in 1995. He set school records for receptions, yardage, and touchdowns in a single season, and broke all Marauder records for career marks in the same categories.
Kevin was just a very, very exciting football player that does a lot of things that coaches can't coach, and he had great quickness from the spot. He could plant and make a move and just accelerate something tremendously and just leave the defender waiting there.
Despite being hampered by late-season injuries, Cannon's phenomenal campaign garnered him a fifth-place finish in balloting for the Harlan Hill Trophy, the Heisman of Division II football. He graduated with 14 school records to his name and left the Marauder faithful with a plethora of memories.
Back at 5, one defender up ahead at the 45. He's inside the 30, down to the 20, the 15, 16.
A new weapon emerged against American International College in the form of junior tailback Gerald Mack, who converted his 4.3 speed into 143 rushing yards and 18 Marauder points in a 39-0 Millersville win. Despite late-season injuries, Mack finished 1995 as Millersville's leading rusher in a three-headed backfield. He exploded for 5 touchdowns from over 30 yards out. Teaming with Mack was freshman Burton Cannon, the younger brother of Kevin, and the team's leader in carries for the 1995 campaign, along with Brady Myers, the team's leader in yards per carry and touchdowns. The three combined for over 1,900 yards rushing and proved a lethal complement to the Marauder passing attack. But Millersville Millersville encountered its first serious test of the year in Week 4 at Clarion. It looked like a cakewalk early as Millersville exploded for touchdowns on 4 consecutive second quarter possessions to grab a 20-6 lead. Junior quarterback Greg Moylan posted prolific numbers, as did his favorite target, number 9. Kevin Cannon caught 17 passes for 202 yards and a score. But Clarion refused to wilt, battling to within 6 late in the fourth quarter. With a minute 16 remaining, Gerald Mack sealed the Marauder victory with a 58-yard touchdown scamper. Greg Moylan's 31-of-40, 444-yard, 3-touchdown performance against Clarion was the pinnacle of a record-shattering season for the junior quarterback. Moylan established school records for completion percentage, touchdown passes, passing yardage, and total offensive yardage in 1995.
He's just a very smart youngster. He has good size. He's a tough kid, and he throws the ball about as well as anybody I've seen this year. And he has great accuracy. He has great confidence in himself. He's the kind of guy that when things are tough, I went in there calling the shots for us.
Moylan's consistency and quiet leadership were key to the success of the 1995 Millersville Marauders. And with a year of eligibility remaining, Greg Moylan is on pace to rewrite the Marauder record books for career passing. Millersville opened its PSAC East Conference schedule at Bloomsburg, and Kevin Cannon took the opening kickoff 87 yards for the touchdown. But the Huskies proved resilient, twice intercepting Greg Moylan in their own end zone. Moylan redeemed himself with a second quarter touchdown strike to Kevin Cannon, giving Millersville a 14-7 lead. A lead that lasted into the fourth quarter, when Bloomsburg evened the score. Greg Moylan put Millersville back atop with a touchdown toss to James Duckett. And Bloomsburg returned the favor, but their point after conversion failed, leaving Millersville with a one-point cushion. And the Marauder offense took advantage, driving 67 yards in 11 plays. Gerald Mack consummated the drive with a 7-yard touchdown sprint to give Millersville a 28-20 lead. But Bloomsburg battled back. With under 3 minutes remaining, the Huskies drove 83 yards in 14 plays for the touchdown. And with Millersville clinging to a 2-point lead, junior safety Robert Drumright was flagged for pass interference on the 2-point conversion.
I thought Robert Drumright just made an outstanding play, and everybody that saw the film thought it was an outstanding play, and unfortunately the official thought he saw something there and threw the flag. And that really hurt because our team was already celebrating on the sidelines. Our kids were jumping on each other out in the field before the flag even hit the ground. And that was an unfortunate situation and adversity that young men and coaches have to overcome. And it wasn't easy. It wasn't an easy situation. Then they come back, get another play, and throw the ball in the end zone for the 2-point conversion to tie us. And that was a low point. That was a low point of the season.
And with the game on the line, the Marauder defense stood tall, forcing Kutztown to punt with 3 minutes and 23 seconds remaining.
To the 25, gets by one man. Near side 30, trips a little bit on his feet at the 35, still on his way. Cuts back at the 40, up ahead 45, 50, has one man to beat. He's down the sideline, hits a straight at the 30, the 25, Cannon still on his feet.
I'll never forget this run as long as I live, or certainly as long as I coach. One of the most fantastic punt returns I've ever seen. He breaks it towards our bench, and to tell you the truth, he was entrapped by three defensive players from Kutztown, and how he got out of that right in front of our bench, I seen it, but couldn't believe it. and he scampered up the field, drug another player with him about 8 yards, and ended up on about the 15-yard line. And just one of the most fantastic punt returns ever in my 30 years of coaching that I've seen. And the real courage is, after that exhausting run and effort, within 35 seconds, he lines up with Michael Dunkerley, who's replaced Greg Moyle in the quarterback, and makes a diving catch at the 1 yard line for a first down and first and goal in the one, and paved the way for Brady Myers' 1 yard run, and then Brandon Lynch's extra point to win the ball game 21-20. That was a great victory. That was a great victory. So things have ways of balancing itself out.
The defense was bolstered throughout the year by a staunch, relentless defensive line. The line was led by seniors Bob Shipp and Jess Karcher. Karcher led the team with 17 quarterback pressures, helping the defense attain 47 sacks in 1995 and consistently thwart dreamy-eyed offensive coordinators. Sophomore Jamar Gordon finished second on the team in sacks, while junior end John Almond finished third in sacks and led the team in turnovers forced. Along with end John Givens, these four provided solid line play throughout the year. The defense and special teams were swarming against Westchester, as they were throughout 1995. Thanks to outstanding special teams play, the Marauders consistently won the battle of field position, averaging 9 yards better per kick return and 5 yards better per punt return than their opponents. Harlan Hill candidate Kevin Cannon provided a game-breaking threat on every return, and he took three of them the distance. Freshman Chad Panabaker handled the punting and kickoffs, while place-kicking duties were capably performed by Brandon Lynch, who converted 11 of his 20 field goals in 1995, and one of his 38 extra points to give Millersville a 7-6 halftime lead at Westchester. Then the Marauder offense exploded for 21 third-quarter points. The defense took care of the rest, and Dale Reed's second interception of the game put the final touches on a 31-12 Millersville victory. The secondary proved clutch throughout 1995. Junior safety Dale Reed led the PSAC in interceptions and finished fourth on the team in tackles, while his cohort Robert Drumright provided a physical presence and quiet leadership. After some early season injuries and uncertainty, Coach Gene Carpenter settled on two freshmen at corner. Stan Sandel led the team in passes defended, while Jamal Battle emerged late in the season to secure the other corner spot. With all four starters returning in 1996, the Millersville secondary should only improve upon its outstanding 1995 showing. And the secondary was just one facet of a swarming, debilitating defense. Gate was homecoming for Millersville at Beamsdurfer Stadium, and the Marauders set to business immediately, nabbing a 19-0 second quarter lead against East Stroudsburg on the strength of two Greg Moylan touchdown passes to junior James Duckett. East Stroudsburg clawed back into the game, but trailing by five and driving in Marauder territory, Dale Reed sealed the 19-14 Millersville win with his seventh interception of the year. J. James Duckett's 8-reception effort against East Stroudsburg was a season high for the junior college transfer who led the team in yards per catch in 1995. Duckett will be looked upon for big things in 96 with the departure of Kevin Cannon and tight end Mark Harmon. Harmon finished 1995 as the second leading Millersville receiver. More importantly, he provided consistent, reliable play at the tight end position.
Mark Harmon played tight end for us for the last 3 years. Has been just outstanding consistency, great efforts. And great efforts is something that I think is indicative of Marauder football players.
The Marauder receiving corps will look for new faces to step up in 1996. Gerald Mack or Brian Cannon may be moved to flanker, where sophomore Brian Filipanix filled in capably when needed, as did Mike McFetrich. Junior Mike Shea finished fourth on the team in receptions as a T-back, and freshman Bill McVeigh is likely to step into the tight end position in 1996. With Gerald Mack and Kevin Cannon injured in week 9 at Cheney, the Marauders needed someone to step up. That someone was junior running back Brady Myers, who picked up 240 yards and 5 touchdowns on only 20 carries.
Off to the right side. He's at the 25-yard line. On his way at the 30. He's at midfield at the 40. In his heading territory at the 30. He's at the 20. The 10. Brady Myers at the 5. Touchdown, Millersville. Brady Myers.
Millersville dominated from start to finish in a 54-0 romp. The Millersville offensive line manhandled Cheney as they controlled opposing teams throughout the year. Millersville averaged over 200 rushing yards per game in 1995 and permitted only 16 sacks. The Marauder offensive line was led by senior Tim Sorber.
Timmy just did a great job for us. Tim got a lot of attention because of his leadership on the football field, his performance on the football field. The players not only liked him, they respected him.
With the exception of Sorber, the 1995 starting offensive line will be back in 1996. Sean Hershey garnered considerable attention for his play at left tackle, and sophomore Chris Wilson matured nicely at center. Though a question mark coming into the 1995 campaign, the Marauder offensive line disproved all doubters, and with four starters returning in 96, the offensive line should be a future strength. The strength of the offensive line was evident in the season finale against Mansfield as the Marauders racked up 387 yards on the ground. With Gerald Mack still injured, Burton Cannon carried for 185 yards.
He's at the 45, he's at the 40, cuts back near side 35, breaks out of a tackle at the 30, it's a foot race at the 20, the 10, Cannon's at the 5, touchdown, Millersville, Burton Cannon.
Brady Myers ran for 136 and the two combined for 3 touchdowns on the ground. Greg Moylan added 2 more through the air as Millersville rebounded from a 14-13 second quarter deficit to score 20 unanswered points in a 41-20 season-ending Marauder victory. Millersville was rewarded for its outstanding season with a bid to the NCAA Division II playoffs, their second bid in the last 8 years, and the Marauders prepared for their postseason appearance with the same tireless work ethic that marked their entire 95 campaign.
If I have to look back on this 1995 football team, the thing that stands out most in my mind about them is the fact that they were really teammates. They really were teammates. Again, seeing it is one thing, being it's another. And
the 14th-seeded Marauders traveled to Big Rapids, Michigan in the opening round of the NCAA Division II playoffs, where they faced the 3rd-seeded Ferris State Bulldogs. And Millersville started auspiciously as Greg Moylan connected with Kevin Cannon for a 46-yard touchdown on Millersville's initial possession. Ferris State evened the score late in the first quarter, but Millersville rebounded with a 90-yard, 19-play touchdown drive to gain a 13-7 halftime lead.
He throws up, Duckett makes the catch, pulls it in, touchdown,
And to see that first half, it couldn't have been played any better. I mean, we were only up 13-7, but the story was on the statistics. The story was the fact that Millersville had had 284 yards total offense, and they had like 80. And that was a big difference. And we come back out, and of course, we're going into the wind. We're going to get the football, but we're going to be going into the wind. And we thought we had a key pattern set up for Kevin, and being injured to just get that one good shot with him. And all, as fate would have it, Greg fell.
Fate turned a cold shoulder to the Marauders in the second half as the Ferris State offense got untracked and assumed the lead that it would never relinquish. But Millersville hung tough, twice pulling within three on Greg Moylan touchdown passes. In the end, however, Ferris State simply had too much artillery.
The great part about being there was the journey itself and what happened on the journey, not necessarily the final results.
And a thrilling journey it was for the Marauder faithful. 1995 was a season full of highlights, and a season that will not soon be forgotten.
To the near side, the 10. Pass the blockers at the 15. Spins at the 20. Cuts it to the outside, the 30. He has one man to beat to the 40. He's at midfield. Cuts back near side. Gets by the kicker. He's at the 30. The 20-yard line. 30-yard line. Spins away from one. Shippensburg Red Raider up the head. He's at the 40. The 45. Cannon at midfield. He's at the 40-yard line. Gets away from one man. Far side, the 30. He's at the 20. Cuts back inside at the 15. The 10. 5. Touchdown, Kevin Cannon. 5 gets by one man. Near side 30, tripped a little bit on his feet at the 35, still on his way, cuts back at the 40, up ahead 45, 50, has one man to beat, he's down the sideline, it's a sprint at the 30, the 25, Cannon, still on his feet.